Hello everybody, welcome back. In this video I am going to show you how to create and add data to a CSV using PowerShell script. So let's get into it. In the current directory I have created a script, PowerShell script named script.json. Json is extensions of PowerShell scripts. So and I have opened that in the VS Code. So let's get into it. What we are going to be doing is first we will be asking user to enter details, and after that we will be storing them in the CSV using PowerShell. So we will be storing information about employees, as you can see in the bash as well as in bash scripts. So we will be storing the name as well as age and address of an employee. We can consider a student as well. But for now, let's consider that is what we are going to be doing. Now, to view this, let's declare a CSV underscore file variable, which will contains the CSV file that we will be creating in the current directory. So let's call it data.csv. And now, first we will ask user or prompt user to enter something. So to do that in PowerShell, we can do it directly. So let's create a name variable and ask user. So we can do read host, and let's enter employee name. We will ask from user, and once he enters that, we will then ask for age. So enter employee age, and the same thing for address. So address, and it's highlighting this because we haven't used this anywhere. So as you can see, the variable name is assigned but never used, so we will use it, no issues. So let's just print them. We can use the right host, we can use echo. Let's use the right host. Let's write the content to the terminal. So name, I want to read the name, age as well as address, and let's save this and let's try it. So to execute that script, you just need to type period and then forward slash and then the script name. Automatically does that for you. If you just type the script name and press tab. Now it asks to enter employee name. Let's say only as you consider in the previous schedule, and then age, and there is something, and voila, here we are displaying them in the terminal. So now we just need to store them in the script in the CSV file. So to do that, we can create a custom object, a custom PowerShell object. So we will do something like PS, I think that is PS custom object here, and then it automatically, now here we will pass the fields that we will be storing there. So then that are name as well as age, and the third one is address. So the name will be that we got from user, so that will be dollar name variable, and the same thing goes for dollar age, and the address is dollar address, and this is double s. So now we will file this to the export CSV, which is the main tool that writes data to a CSV. So now we will need to pass the CSV file, which is right here. So I will just copy it from there. Now if I save this, remove that, I'm trying to format it but it's not a formatting, no issue. Now let's try it. So we created a custom PowerShell object, and then we pass these keys, which are name, age and address. We assign these values, which is a name, age and address that we pass from the user. So once that is done, let's try it. So execute the script again. Let's say Ali, and age is and you might have noticed here that we don't have that file created. So export CSV automatically creates that file for you. So now the age is 45 and address is something, and no error. So here we can, you can see we have the CSV file created. with the headers as well as the data that we pass from here. Now you might notice here the type and displays the type at the top. So that is a system management automation PS custom object. So we need to remove that. To do that, we can pass a flag to the export CSV that has no type information. That automatically completes that for me. So let's try it again. And if I go back and I clear the screen and execute the script again, oh, it has data.csv. So control X, script.ps1, and name is Ali, age is 45, and address is something. Something is, and try it. So now that is done. And if I go back, as you can see, we don't have the type information. Now let's try it again. There is another issue that I am trying to show you guys. So let's say another user is on, and age is let's say 50 and some address. This was spaces. Let's see if that is going to throw some errors. No error. So we should find them in the CSV. As you can see, it here we were having already a data. So now it is overwritten. So we don't like overwriting the existing data again and again. We want to append the a lot of data to this. So to do that, we can pass a flag for that as well, and that is append. So now we will be appending data to that. So the first user that we created is not here, so let's create that again and see if it's going to overwrite the existing one. So the name was Ali, the address 45, and some errors, and no error. And let's go back, and here you can see we append that data to that CSV. That's how you can create and store data in a CSV using a PowerShell script. So the main command is this. It's a lot of flags, as you can see. The path, we can directly pass it here, and we can write the flag name as well, like the path, and then passing the path name. So the path is the CSV underscore file is in the current directory, and then we are passing the append flag to append the content, and then we have others like ports. If somehow you are not able to add or append data, you can force up in that as well. And then we have some other flags as well, but these are the most useful flags, especially when creating PowerShell scripts. So that's it for this video. Make sure to like and subscribe to this channel. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next one.